so we're going to be working on the main bracket base. This is actually the bottom. We're going to be drilling four holes, and we're going to be thread milling two holes. The two holes will be for to secure the chain and the air spring, and these through holes will be to mount the bracket. Machining the bottom first so that I can clamp it, because once it gets all machined out, I won't be able to easily secure it in the vise. So we'll do the bottom first, and then we'll actually start machining out the profile. So let's get started. So what we've got here are, this is the bottom, and so these will be the two bolt holes to mount it to the top of the column, and these two holes here. One, I'm going to modify a bolt to connect to my chain, and then that's going to secure in one hole, like so, and there'll be a jam nut. And then the other hole here that's threaded is for my air spring to screw down into. So now that we've got the bottom machine, we're going to flip it on the side, and we're going to do the whole profile. All right, so I've got my stock in here. This is 5 inches by 9 inches. It was a little too big to actually fit between the jaws of my vise, so I have affixed it to the outside configuration. We're going to be doing some boring, some thread milling, some contouring, and some adaptive. And this should get most of it, and then we'll flip it over and finish it off. So let's get started. turned out really good. This whole piece took me an hour and 8 minutes. Yeah, pretty long time. These are M4 threads. Turned out nice. So now the way this is going to go together, these pieces with the sprocket will fit on there like so, that we did in the last video. There we go. And the one up front. Really nice. Turned out really good. So we're going to go ahead and flip this over. Pretty satisfied with the way the machine's machining these parts. As you can see, really nice finish there. On the side cutting. Now this particular piece, I had to face this right here. Actually, I had to face the whole thing before I did the adaptive. If I tried to face this particular portion right here, which is all I really need to face off, if I tried to do that after doing the adaptive, the adaptive cam operation would actually machine this surface too, and I didn't want that, so I went ahead and faced off the whole piece and then came back and did the adaptive. I didn't want these lines. You can see these little lines. I mean, it feels flat, but there's still lines there, and I know it's not quite flat. So anyways, really happy with the side finish on this piece. So now we just need to flip it over, get set up, and face off this extra material here. It's about 100 thousandths or so. Okay guys, so I've got my piece flipped over like so, and I'm still referencing off this corner here. This is now my zero. I have this clamp between here and these two edges right here, and this part right here is just kind of hanging over. So what I've done is I've put a piece of stock underneath to try to give it a little support so that I don't have a vibration and give me a bad finish when I face this off. I'm hoping this is going to work. I just didn't want to machine some kind of fixture for this to be in just for two pieces. If I was doing a production run, I'd probably machine some kind of fixture so that this would be supported when facing these off. But I'm going to take a chance here. We'll see how it turns out. So I left about 50 thousandths all the way around, and that'll be all right. We'll just face the rest of this off. Okay, So I've slid this piece up under here that's going to support this when I go to face it off and prevent it from chattering. I tried doing it without supporting it, but it just chattered too bad. So this way I think it's going to work. We're going to give it a try. I'm going to go slow and take, I'm taking about 35 thousandths per pass. I don't want to rush it because I don't want to get any chatter. Let's see what we've got. Alright, no chatter. Man, I'm really happy with that. Now that I've got the extra stop removed, the next step is to do the two mounting holes. Remember, we bored those in the first operation, and now we're going to do the other side, which is just a counter bore, so the head of the screws will be recessed. We're going to be using M6 bolts there, so we're going to get set up and we're going to do that. Really happy with the way that the support worked here. It kept it from chattering. I was really concerned about that. I didn't want to mess up the finish of the piece. Set up and we'll do the counter bores, and that should. Okay, so I've got the piece clamped up in the vise now, and we're going to be doing our counter bore. This will be for the M6 socket head cap screws. Now, my zero is set from this back edge, the top here of the model, and this side right here. Alright, so let's run these parts. So you can see we just counterbored these holes so that we can sink the head of the screw in there. Alright, so one more to do, and then we should be wrapping this up. Alright guys, well there's the finished piece. I've still got to button it up, get some nuts to go in the back. There's a little play here, so I've got to make some washers to go in there. I did the same thing. I got to just make some washers to go in there. Those are the mounting screw holes there for some M6. Looks pretty good. My end mill was not quite long enough. It kind of gouged my piece there. The collet caught on there, or the nut for the ER16. The nut kind of caught it, but that's okay. Probably could shallow that up a little bit, maybe. Overall, I think it turned out really nice, and we'll get it mounted. You may ask why this bolt right here is not in line with these other two, like on this side. Well, I plan on trying to drill and tap a hole here to go through the rail and bolt this to the rail as well. Alright guys, so that wraps up this video. In the next video, we're going to try to get everything assembled. There's some work, a couple of holes. We've got a bore and tap for the Z saddle. We'll get that in the next video, and we'll try to get it assembled, and that should finish up this counterbalance video series. I think should be four videos in total, but we'll just have to see. All these videos seem to run long. I tried to edit the machining in this video a little bit. The whole machining process for this was about over an hour. So that wraps up this video. If you're new to my channel and you're interested in the video content, click on the subscribe button down here in the bottom corner. That way, whenever I post a new video, you'll get a link. And if it's something you're interested in, you can stop by and check it out. As always, guys, thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Thumbs up if you like the video. And most importantly, be safe.